So this is the first case challenging the constitutionality of Republic Act 9646. This one, very influential, ano to, yung developers group. Narinig niyo na siguro itong grupo nila. Chamber of Real Estate and Builders Association. Sinama na yung isang developer, Reman Enterprises Inc. No? Siguro isa, one of those na affected no sa implementation ng RESA versus Professional Regulatory Board of Real Estate Service and the Professional Regulation Commission. So what happened this case? Briefly, yung facts lang. So way back last December 7, 2010, these petitioners, no, Reman Enterprises and CREBA, instituted civil case number 10124776 in the Regional Trial Court of Manila, RTC Manila, Branch 42. So marami silang allegations, but the centerpiece of their attack was to declare as void and unconstitutional Section 28 of Republic Act number 9646. Ito yung ayaw nila, yung Section 28 ng RA 9646. So let's go into Section 28, no, directly. Bakit ayaw to ng CREBA? Section 28 of Republic Act 9646 covers exemptions from the acts constituting the practice of real estate service. Exemptions. No? Because the general rule under, you can only practice real estate, the real estate professions under Section 3G of RESA if you are a licensed real estate professional. Or if you're not a real estate, if you're not a licensed real estate professional, just like a consultant, appraiser, assessor, or broker, you are an accredited salesperson. Yun yung general rule, no? But there's an exemption clause sa exemption provision sa RESA, exempting no certain persons or certain acts from the from yung ano to, yung mandatory compliance with the licensing requirements of RESA. So ibig sabihin, exemption, no, general rule, kailangan mo ng license. What is the first exemption? The first exemption is under Section 28A. Now let's just read it, no, but this is a very simple provision. Any person, natural or juridical, who shall directly perform by himself, herself, the acts mentioned in Section 3. Yung Section 3 class, no, dapat familiar tayo. Lumabas na rin sa board exam. Section 3 enumerates who are the real estate professionals. No? So nakalagay dito sa A, exempting these persons if you perform directly or you perform directly the acts mentioned in Section 3 hereof with reference to his or her or its own property. Okay? Medyo mahaba-haba na kalito. But ang sinabi lang dito, class, yung Section 3A, kung ikaw yung may-ari ng property mo, you don't need to be a broker, no, to sell your property. You don't need to be a consultant, no, to make an opinion about your ano to, yung feasibility ng project mo, kasi ikaw yung may-ari, or you're even exempted from stating a valuation. Di ba yung mga may-ari, sometimes their pricing is bloated. But you can render an opinion as to pricing if you're the owner. So in short, if you're the owner, no, dito lang tayo sa mga broker para maintindihan natin, you don't need a license to sell your property. That is the exemption to the general rule that you need a license. Now, is there an exemption to the is there an exception to the exemption? There is, no, pinpoint dito yung mga real estate developers. Okay, in short, if you're a developer, No, yung developer, you're the owner of your project, di ba? Even if you're the owner of your project, you are not exempted from complying with the provisions of Section 3G of RESA. Meaning, you cannot sell your own property if you're a developer. Okay, clear? Ito yung ayaw ng CREBA. Kasi sabi ng CREBA, may-ari kami. No? May-ari kami ng subdivision, yung condominium. Why will you require us na yung pagbenta ng project namin idaan sa license broker? Yan that's the precise attack by CREBA yung sa provisions ng RESA. So ito yung A, no? If you're the owner, you're exempted. But the exception to the exemption if you're the real estate developer. So lumabas, no? Fast forward lang, umabot sa Supreme Court. No, sabi ng ano to, sabi ng CREBA, unconstitutional yung RESA because it violates the due process clause. No, sabi ng ano to, due process clause. Bakit? Kasi parang tinanggal mo yung karapatan nila, no, to dispose of their property despite owner sila. Okay, sabi ng CREBA, that is the most basic na ownership right, the right to use and the right to dispose the property in accordance with Article 428 of the Civil Code. Diba? Yung bundle rights, pinag-aralan natin yan, no? Sa ibang subject nyo. So yun yung sabi ng CREBA, eh bakit nyo naman ipagkait sa amin yan? May-ari kami. So there's no need daan sa mga brokers yan. So sabi ng trial court yan, yung RTC, for you to know yung reasoning, no? Reasoning ng korte, yung regional trial court, eh sabi ng RTC, hindi naman kayo pinagbabawal na ano to, na hindi naman pinagbabawal ng batas yung pagbenta nyo, no? Except lang that if you sell, you have to secure the services of a licensed real estate broker. Kasi the real estate broker, in accordance with RESA, is the one who will oversee the actions of yung mga unlicensed real estate practitioners. Yung tinatawag nating mga ano to, color room ng mga agents, no? Color room na salespersons, kailangan within the ambit of mga licensed brokers. Diba? Kayo class, dumaan kayo ng matinding screening, no? Yung pag-aaral, the reason is for you to guide your salespersons, no? In order to for them to be compliant with the provisions of RESA. Eh sabi ng, that's the argument ng RTC. Hindi naman pinagbabawal yan eh. Pero kung magbenta kayo, idaan nyo sa mga ano to, brokers. Now, because the law, RESA, prescribes requirements for the regulation of the practice of real estate services. Pwede bang gawin ng ano to? Pwede bang gawin ng gobyerno yan to prescribe yung requirements? The answer, favorite question sa board exam to, that's part of the state's valid exercise of the state's police power. Diba, mga fundamental powers of government, no? Isa na yung taxation, police power, eminent domain, no? So kasama yan, sabi ng korte, part ng ano to, yung regulation na yan is part of the exercise of the police power of the state. Tapos, what about yung equal protection clause? Now, when you say equal protection clause, eh bakit yung mga ibang owners, they'll be allowed to sell? Why is it na yung mga developers, they're not allowed to sell unless na dadaan sa mga brokers? So, what the court use, no, to differentiate yung mga developers from ordinary owners, tinatawag nilang concept of reasonable classification. Kahit na may-ari kayo, no, mga subdivision project, malaking project, dapat ka-classify kayo from the ordinary na mga ano to, mga owners. So that is the justification of the RTC, yung tinatawag na reasonable classification. Why? Why is there a need that yung sa mga developers should be classified differently from ordinary sellers, ordinary owners? The reason is part of yung power ng gobyerno, no, to classify to classify yung nature ng ownership nila, because if you're a developer, you normally sell large numbers of mga real estate projects. And syempre, kung kung malakihan, kung hindi mo i-regulate yan, there's a chance na marami ding maloko. In contrast with yung tinatawag nilang isolated sale transactions made by private individuals selling their own property. So ikaw lang, you don't need a license. So tama yung RESA dyan according to Supreme Court. But kung dadaan sa developers na maraming units yung binibenta nila, then with more reason that there's a need to protect the general public. Dapat idaan natin yan sa mga professionals. So nakuha nyo class, ito yung target na kinukuha nyo na license. You're given that obligation to ensure that the public is protected from yung tinatawag na unscrupulous and unethical real estate practices. Yan, kinlasify, na tinatawag na reasonable classification. Yung mga real estate developers daw, they sell lots, houses, and condominium units in the ordinary course of business, which according to the court, is a business which is highly regulated to ensure the health and safety of home and lot buyers. So remember, yung reason ng law mismo, the reason that you're studying this course should be impressed on us that we have a huge obligation to the general public as licensed professional brokers. So in that, there's a substantial distinction. May pagkakaiba between yung ordinary property owners na who are exempted under Section 28. No, remember Section 28, kung lalabas man sa board exam to, ang question normally is, what section under RESA prescribes for exemption sa practice ng requirement ng licensing requirements ng RESA? Ganun type of questions. It's very good na mga type of mga questions that will be asked sa board exam. So that's it. Sabi ng Supreme Court, there's a reasonable and relevant classification. And with that, CREBA lost sa Supreme Court. Sabi ng Supreme Court, the court thus rules that RA number 9646 is valid and constitutional. So in short, it's a victory sa profession natin, mga licensed real estate brokers. Ang Korte Suprema mismo, Supreme Court mismo yung nagsabi na dapat lahat ng benta ng mga developers should be coursed through licensed real estate brokers. Nawala yung mga sinasabi ng mga in-house. You can have in-house as long as the one heading yung department is a licensed real estate broker. Pero meron tayong narinig na mga ganyan, yung mga circumvention ng mga developers, no need kasi in-house daw. So that violates also yung RESA law with, as explained by the Supreme Court in this case of CREBA versus PRC.